There you go.
Yeah, dude.
Man, big fan in this.
You on it, dude? Watch out, coming back again. How you doing?
Yeah.
We're the big bird.
Free BG, man.
Oh, geez, hey. I say, oh, geez, hey. Holla at your boy, man.
Yeah. That was good old days,
that's
man.
That's that throwback, though.
What it do, man?
And guess what? We on full flat steel road.
Yeah, sure.
You understand?
Making all kind of noise. You don't understand, but you get it. Probably not, because we ain't going to give it to you.
Well, how y'all doing today? You understand?
I'm on saying this BG.
We jamming out this BG, you understand?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Shoot me right now. I hope you can hear it, man. Free BG, man. That money is on it, but he doesn't need it.
So my nigga L Pen was popping on it, but... Yeah.
There we go, man. Let's get started, man. What it do, man? He tuned in to the live line on New Orleans Talk Network. I'm your host, L Pen.
Yeah, Stan, this madman, the big fan.
Yeah, sure. That's my guest for the night. Y'all gonna rock with us tonight, man.
Yeah, I'm a fan of everything.
I see from the shirt. I see you're a fan.
Yeah.
You look at life through the fan view. You know what I'm saying?
I know y'all used to seeing me on fan view. You heard me, but yes, I love music. So I'm traveling tonight.
Yeah, sure. I'm glad to have you, homie.
Oh, you already know.
It's real talk about real rap over here, man. It's the live line every Tuesday, so you know we gonna talk about it. We got some music tonight, but we gonna talk about it. We got a few things we was discussing before the show started.
Oh boy.
Some things at home and abroad.
Oh boy.
Free BG, man.
Oh boy.
Long live Bono TV.
You understand? Oh geez.
As always, man. Long live Bono TV. But we're going to get right into it, man. We was checking out the interview with the boy Kanye. And we was discussing some of the many rants. I don't know how many there were exactly over time. There's been a few rants, man, that he's had. So we was discussing a few of them. Yeah. Something like that.
I don't know what to say about Kanye. Right? I really don't. I can't really speak on Kanye because I don't know if I want to accept the fact that he's claiming emotional distress, like he's having problems. I don't know, but
exactly what is defined as emotional distress?
I don't know. I think it's messed up sexual tendencies, but that's just me.
How did you get that from emotional distress? Anyway,
I'm not paying attention to what everybody's saying. I'm going off of what Amber Rose said, and too many of those to the back shot there might mess with your central lobe.
and that's right after that. And that's what it is.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave that alone because I you know what?
I'm gonna just pray about real rap.
All I can
man.
Do is pray for him. I hope he get his mind right. Even though you know he does talk some real things that people should pay attention to, but it's hard to pay attention to him when he loses focus. So how you gonna expect you to stay focused on what he's saying when he losing focus on what he's saying?
No. Well, I feel like, you know, with the interview we watched, it was about a half an hour, right? About 35 minutes. We watched that interview, and it didn't seem scripted at all. It seemed like his answers were being given in real time. And whenever you're talking in real time, like, you know, like we're doing now, you're going to stop and think and try to paint a picture that is as universally understood as possible. And to me, I felt like he was doing that. From my take of it, the interview was it wasn't scripted, you know, it was off the cuff. So yeah, I think I agree with you. At times he did drift.
manager. He drifted so far, he tore the side of his Bentley up. That's how far he was drifting off. Like, I hope. I mean, of course, he probably got A1 insurance, but why? It's not worth it. Like, don't think and drive. Just drive. That's just me. Don't take a drive.
I feel like I disagree. I feel like we got too many people doing that now. We got too many people not thinking and driving.
I mean, I'm not saying don't handle your business correctly. You see what I'm saying? Like, don't be a puppet to the industry. But at the same time, don't lose your mind like Kanye. Stay focused.
So, in your opinion, you feel like he lost his, you feel like he out his mind?
I think he out his body. Me personally, like, if there's some new form of drug, he has found it. I'm serious. It just hasn't come out yet. But haha, we will see.
So you think? Yeah, it was a 35-minute interview with Surface Magazine. But you feel like this is drug induced? Like, you feel like all the rants or the byproduct or side effect of some foreign substance?
You know how some people start getting in touch with certain sides of themselves and they start learning themselves? I think Kanye didn't touch too many sides of himself. You see what I'm saying? And
this is the result? The outcome.
This is what you get. You get a mentally charged person with money and don't take shit.
So you heard it from Madman, a big fan on the live line. If you learn too many sides of yourself, if you get in touch with too many sides of yourself, you wind up having incomplete discussions or rants with a bunch of a combination of run-on sentences and fragments. Don't make no sense. And then what you say? You make a lot of money and you don't. You don't say nothing.
I'm not too much of a superstitious person, but I do believe in the Kardashian curse. That shit is real.
What is that?
That's Lamar Odom going crazy. Messing with Chloe?
I thought that was crack. Huh? I thought you was on crack. You was on Chloe? It wasn't the crack, it was the Chloe?
It was the Chloe crack.
The Chloe crack.
He called it the clover.
Kardashian crack.
Man, I'm telling you, bro. That's just me. So I can only speak on what I feel.
So is anybody else is just Lamar and possibly Kanye? Can you call it a curse after just one person?
Well, no, you have to call it a curse if it's more than one person.
Yeah.
But you got to look at it. You know, people start dying and dropping around the family and stuff, but they butts still get bigger.
Yeah, okay.
Probably like the sacrifice of the buttocks.
So they sacrificing successful black dudes for butt cheeks?
And Botox.
It's a possibility.
You hey, silly, man. Hey.
Yeah.
It is what it is. But all I'm going to say is, Jay told you don't marry him. Should have listened.
Wife, has it been problems in the marriage that make you feel like that?
You know what? I would prefer for the people to just, you know, if we can get this clip and let y'all see, if y'all haven't seen what Kanye likes to talk when he's doing the interview.
I haven't heard or I haven't seen too many people upset with his interviews. I think people mainly have an issue with these, or the most attention is given to these rants that are done in the middle of concerts. I could be wrong. Get on that Facebook fan page, man. New Orleans Talk Network. Leave comments. Let me know. Am I right or wrong? Is it the Kardashian curse? Is Madman correct?
I'm going to say this.
Let me know. Facebook fan page, New Orleans Talk Network. Call in 504-341-8255. Let me know. You think you got it, man?
Well, you know, I mean,
I could be wrong.
I wouldn't be able to interview Kanye.
No,
I couldn't do it.
Why not? Why not?
Well, because his arrogance would cause a lawsuit, and I don't have the type of money Kanye wants.
Well, we're going to get into this quick video from the homie Mike Ventures, and when we get back, we're going to discuss that, man. But I want to know exactly why you feel like you can't interview him. So you wouldn't want him on the live line?
Oh, I mean, I would love for him to be here, but that you would have to interview him.
So I'd be...
If Kanye was to walk up in here right now...
I'd be very honored to do it.
If Kanye was to come up in here right now and start going off on a rant talking about I'm watching y'all live and I'm seeing what y'all doing and I don't like what you saying,
I'm gonna just say Jesus, yay man, and he gonna feel good, so he gonna chill out.
I mean, I don't know.
Or just put a picture of Kim out, he'll feel better.
I'm sorry, I don't let the roaches in the neighbor house disrespect me. You understand, dog? The next door neighbor dog. Look, you got a line. Look, yeah, we got a problem.
Oh, man.
Your head, like swim well.
The neighbors got the roaches and even more so disrespectful roaches. We ain't going to be neighbors that long. That's not good, man. But we'll get into that after this video, man. Shout out to the homie Mike Ventures, man. Y'all check this out. We'll be back to talk about it. It's the live line on New Orleans Talk Network. Every Tuesday, 7 to 8 p.m. I got Madman, a big fan in here.
It is.
From the Fan View, joining me
only on New Orleans Talk Network.
Hey boy, it's no time to make these moves, son. You little, you just put out that mind heavy on the grind. Man, we gotta make some money, man. What y'all think?
Shit, I'm thinking.
Thank you, Cole. Cole, man, you probably gonna let me have left, bro. It's gonna be easy.
Man, no, man. I'm telling you, Mike. I'm telling you, bro. I can handle it.
Nah,
I can handle it.
Son,
don't go nowhere, son. I'm telling you, son. I'm gonna fuck with y'all, man. I'm doing this. I'm coming back.
Dude, I'm telling you, son. Don't
leave, son. Son. Dog. Girl, don't stop.
No.
Girl, don't stop.
No.
Girl, don't stop. Girl, don't stop.
No.
Girl, don't stop.
No.
Girl, don't stop.
I said, don't stop now.
I said, don't stop now. Don't stop now. Don't stop now. But 100K tonight, I wanna spend it on you, spend it all on you. Cause I heard that bands make her dance, so I'm gonna take a chance and get these bills to you. Get these bills to you. Cause I love the way it moves, and you got me in the mood. So baby, don't you stop what you're doing. Girl, don't stop. 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 Girl, don't stop.
I said, don't stop now.
I said, don't stop now. Don't stop now. Don't stop now.
This is the cause I'm feeling like few. I'm young and stuff, baby, I do what I do. I think I'm in love, how she making it move. I reach out my hand and I see that it's loose. After the club, we could go get a room. She taking them shots, I'm pouring the juice. She was mad at the club, then got left at the room. When I count up my dough, I could fill up a room. I can have anything up in this room. I remember my name, Capito the Truth. I don't do clubs, to tell you the truth. I just hit up your phone and just tell you come through. When in that pussy, I'm making a fool. If the bitch bad, I treat her like food. I tell her don't stop it, just do what you do. I tell her don't stop it, just do what you do. She strippin' to wishes, she going to school. She smart in them books, but she do what she do. Intelligent chick, but ain't nice to get loose. She strip for a lot, but she fuck with a few. Why talk about her, she look better than you. Why talk about her, she look better than you. Do you?
Girl, don't stop. Girl, don't stop. Girl, don't stop.
I said don't stop now.
Girl, don't stop. Girl, don't stop. Girl, don't stop.
I said don't stop now.
I said don't stop now. Don't stop now. Don't stop now.
I said, it's a lot of money for a car wash in the hood. I think we did good. What you think?
Stop. Hey, girl.
Look at this clown.
Hey, girl.
What's up, son?
Hey, I'm
late.
Man.
You late to the car wash.
I'm late to the car wash.
Why you don't see these 20s in my hand, boy?
That's money from yesterday.
Oh, no, this from the car wash, JB.
That's from the car wash? Y'all ate today, huh?
Yeah, we did.
I done missed all the bitches, man.
Everything.
I done missed all the bitches.
You can
get
that.
Yeah, I'm about to go buy me a good nice tank of golf.
'Cause my guest host, Madman, a big fan.
Yeah.
From the fan view, he said if Kanye came, you wouldn't be able to interview him.
Mm-mm.
And the first thing you said because of the arrogance.
Yeah.
Before we get to that, man, shout out to Mike Ventures, my homie. Did a real nice video there, nice song. And shout out to Woodman, shout out to Madman for catching that. He said, "Wait, man, I know that hood."
I'm from the West Bank. You give me a bird's eye view of anything on that street, I'm gonna tell you. I know where you at.
Shout out to Woodman. Mm-hmm. But let's get back into it, man. It's the live line on New Orleans Talk Network, man. It's real talk about real rap. So why wouldn't you be able to interview Kanye? You say he's arrogant.
I'm arrogant.
You arrogant.
Yeah, I'm arrogant in a cool way, though. But at the same time, his arrogance and my...
It's not going to make...
Dude.
It's not going to make a great interview?
Madman. Madman arrogance. Madman arrogance.
Man, yeah.
It's a problem. I'm sorry.
We should have seen it coming.
Yeah, it's almost like you wanted it to happen.
Nah. It's not like we reality TV.
Yeah, we are.
Shutting up shitty scenario.
Yes.
We don't do such thing. We do not partake in such endeavors over here at the New Orleans Talk Network.
Nah.
But if we are present and such endeavors take place organically without our doing, we have no choice. Who are we to not?
I ain't gonna lie, I get a reality show for Mardi Gras. Just for Mardi Gras season. Just around that time. Just gotta follow me and record me just for Mardi Gras. That's it. Reality TV. Did I throw that in there? I'm sorry.
Mardi Gras?
Yeah.
Madman?
Yeah. That's when it goes down.
Setting up bad scenarios.
Mm-hmm.
and record them. Reality TV. Yeah. So that's what you would do instead of interviewing Kanye. While he was here being getting interviewed, you would be doing that.
Yeah. Yeah.
It is making sense now.
I'll be in my comfort zone, like, you know, I'm on the court.
So you can't interview him because he's arrogant, and you'd be busy with a Mardi Gras reality TV show.
Yeah, I just make other plans.
I'd do it.
Either that or just go home and lay down and watch some TV. Watch Sanford and Son.
Okay.
Well, I mean, my thing is what?
Not Mardi Gras. No reality TV show.
No, I'm just saying, like, because it's Kanye West,
you just
know,
not want to do it.
I'm not. Put it like this. I've never been the type of person to, like, go crazy behind an artist or a celebrity or anything like that. Don't get me wrong. I like their music. If I like their music, you know.
Yeah, and shout out to the city, man. This is New Orleans. We don't do the starstruck thing. You come here and feel like you're at home. We ain't going to bother you.
I'm sorry.
We don't get no fucks.
I hear people go crazy. Oh, such and such is going to be down here doing a concert. I'd rather listen to it on CD or something else. Like, no, I go download the music. Because I'm not for the performing. Like, if I'm coming, like, dude, see, if I come to your show, why the hell am I performing? Why am I doing shit? I paid for the ticket, like.
Logical question.
You do.
That's a fair question.
Fuck, I want to see you do cartwheels. pump it up. For real. Shit. I'm comfortable at
home. He wants your money's worth.
I'm going to get my money's worth. If I'm going, I'm getting my money's worth.
So you would have...
Yeah, I know.
But you wouldn't do the free interview.
Free?
Yeah.
What Kanye was?
Yeah.
No.
You don't even have to pay for it. And you get the same performance. You'll get a performance for free.
But then I just wouldn't do it. Like, I'm not really big on Kanye. I was when he first came out, you know.
Me personally, I don't think he is as crazy as people make him out to be. I think people do a lot more judging. I think people doing a little more judging than listening. It's some things sprinkled in there. It's some shit that makes sense. You know, just sprinkled in there. If you you know, you gotta listen. It's kind of hard to listen. And I will say it's kind of hard to listen when you're being screamed at. So, you know, if he could chill out with the screaming and kind of, you know, just talk to you, nigga. You know, all that screaming and yelling and shit. Your mic's already loud. We at your concert and now like, you're screaming at me and shit. You make me kind of feel like I don't want to be here.
Real.
It's not a safe place. You seem very upset. Are you going to leave? Is this an argument? Should I scream back? I don't know. You know, just talk to your nigga Kanye. Just talk. Stop screaming at the people. Just talk to them. But aside from that, you know, if you can get past the screaming and kind of listen to what he's saying, some of it makes sense. A percentage of it. No? You don't think so? No.
What?
There's a percentage of the things he screams at you that makes sense. Some of them.
I mean, certain things Kanye talk about are logical things to think of. But that's like, it's almost like having a crackhead be your pharmacist. Like, this the person that's supposed to supply that drug, that knowledge that you need to hear. But it's coming from a crackhead.
But then...
If you walked into the pharmacy to get your drugs,
would it,
and a crackhead was behind the counter that you knew smoked crack...
Would there ever be any drugs left for you to get? That is...
Nah. I'm just not with Kanye.
I'd go to
I'm not with his antics. I'm not with his attitude.
Walgreens.
I don't even care what his cause is anymore. CVS. Like, I'm done with dude. I cut. I man, look.
So, well, what did it for you? At what point were you done with it?
The Taylor Swift thing was funny. You know, yeah. But his rants and antics getting...
Sorry, Taylor. It was funny as shit.
I mean, I don't know what the deal is between him, Jay, and B. Like, what kind of relationship they had. But somebody's in their feelings. And it's not the one with the ring on. Because there's only two that can wear that ring, and there's three. I think that was the
think
problem.
Think that's what it is?
Yeah, he allowed himself to become a third wheel and feel some kind of way when, you know.
Can you be a third wheel when you're married?
Hell yeah.
Is that possible? Like a married third wheel? You got a fourth wheel, but we don't count it. You're a third wheel.
When you just jump up.
Don't count down.
On national TV doing an award and take the mic from a young lady that won an award. Yeah. And say, y'all know this is wrong. Beyonce deserve best video of the year.
It's not passionate.
But who the fuck are you?
It's not zealous.
Who the hell are you?
Kanye West.
What the?
I'm helping. I'm helping.
But my thing is,
you asking me? No.
I'm just saying, like, people. I thought it was funny, cause I'm like, man, this
yeah,
dude don't
yeah,
love.
It was funny. I thought her face.
Like, what was he?
I
drinking?
Thought her face was funny. If you look at her face. It was funny as shit. She kind of had the who the hell are you face. She had the madman, the big fan face. Hey, who the hell are you? You crooked face, motherfucker.
I mean, then he said it like a female would say it. Y'all know Beyonce had the best video of the year. You see what I'm saying? Like, man, check dude, man. Check his tampon, too.
Jesus. Yay, man.
Hey. Dude,
oh man, that's
it's
about it. Yeah, all right, it's real talk about real rapping here, man. You tuned into the Live Line on New Orleans Talk Network. That's Mad Man, the big fan. I'm your host, Ill Penn, and we're gonna get into this next video from Shia Nut, man. It's very fitting because Mad Man is in here going bananas, so we're gonna get into this bananas with Kid with Shia Nut featuring the homie Kid. And then we're going to get back. We'll come back, man. We're gonna wrap this up. We got something else to talk about. But
I wonder if Kanye went bananas when he heard that song, Bananas. It's just bananas.
Fair question. Fair question.
Hey, he could do a lot with some bananas. You understand? Hey, check him.
I have no clue. I don't want to know. I don't want to know.
Bitch go bananas, I got them all gone bananas. Bitch, I go bananas. The shy, you go dumb. I'm like a park with no swings, bitch. I ain't no fun. The beat kicking like Jet Li, but I ain't the one. And half of y'all junk. Yeah, sound for the sun. Bitch, I'm bananas. My wrist ain't bananas. You better stay around your bitch, cause my dick ain't bananas. They try to tell me turn up, I tell them I go bananas. I got a bitch in the Benz and a bitch in the Phantom. Got a bitch in Detroit and a bitch in Montana. And your bitch act like a monkey, but you want that shy banana. If she ever say I'm small, I'ma sue her for slander. Put Jupiter out of business, I'm slinging bananas. Bitch, I'm bananas. My wrist ain't bananas. I got a bitch, she bananas. I got them all gone bananas. Bananas. My wrist game bananas. I got a bitch, she bananas. I got a mug on bananas. Bitch go bananas. Bitch go bananas. Bitch go bananas. I got a mug on bananas. Bitch go bananas. Bitch go bananas. Bitch go bananas. I got a mug on bananas.
Bitch go bananas. Pockets fatter than hammers. From coke and Norman Hammer. Pour four in the Phantom. Am I fucking you tonight? I hope I get the right answer. I just want a little sample. Pump your back like a camel. Shh. How I'm shitting on them, I might need me a pamper. Always catch me in the streets because the kid ain't a rapper. Bitch, I'm too hot to handle. I'm lit like a candle. Take your hoe like the Phantom. Up in the Phantom. She gave me brain like she just graduated from Stanford. Drunk in love, we woke up in the kitchen like what just happened. Bitch, I'm bananas. This clip is bananas. My click is bananas. That split your apple. My whip is bananas. Just look how it peel off. My shoes are red bottom. Cause the shit make me feel tall. I take the right bitch, then I do a real wrong. She said I know they call you kid kid, but you real grown.
Bitch, I'm bananas. I'm bananas. My wrist ain't bananas. I got a bitch, she bananas. I got a mug on bananas. Bitch, I'm bananas. My wrist ain't bananas. I got a bitch, she bananas. I got a mug on bananas.
Live line on New Orleans Talk Network. I'm your host, Ill Pen. I got the homie Madman, a big fan. We in here. We vibing off the music. Recite over there cutting up, man. First,
man, shout out to the old No Limit, man.
We had the old Cash Money first.
Understand?
The No Limit and the Cash Money. Shout out to that rivalry and that movement and that era.
I don't know about that new No Limit. I don't know. I can't.
Nah, the old No Limit. Old Cash Money.
Yeah, buddy.
The new No Limit is a no. Well, I ain't gonna say that. Shout out to the old Cash Money.
But check this out. Oh, I got one last thing to say about Kanye West. And if anybody knows him personally and you are watching this, please give him this video and let him see this. And let him know, yes, I really want to know who the fuck made you the presidential speaker for all black people.
When that happened?
That's that what happened. He's doing. I like Kanye feels his cause and his position in life. He feels like he's at a point in life to where he can put his foot down on everything. With them corporate people in the industry, play that, homie. When it comes to real life, stay in your lane because you have none.
Who said this? He said that?
Somebody I'm said that? This.
Oh, you said
it. I'm saying okay. This.
He just speaks as though he's our spokesperson. Oh, the spokesperson for...
Yes, he does.
Oh, okay. Nah, I'm good.
I'm sorry.
He said what you wanted him to say? Did you tell him?
Man, you got what homo, you wanted him to you say? Got homo tendencies, man. Look, you can't he speak didn't. For everybody. You got to only speak for yourself.
Man, Scyther's over here cutting up. Now we got the Juve in the background. It's going down, man. It's a serious 504 mix going on in the headphone. You know what I'm saying? Old Cash Money. Old No Limit. No New No Limit.
No new. No. Can't do it. Yeah.
No New Friends. No New No Limit.
Nah.
No New.
Oh, and to all my people out there that's out of state who know me, who be hitting me up online and stuff, and, you know, be checking out what Madman the Big Fan be doing. Yeah, I am all right. I did not go on Bourbon Street for Bayou Classic. No, I don't go out there anymore. That's for the younger society. So I stay at home. I was home with my daughter, so I'm good. But yes,
you look good. You're here.
We did have a mass shooting over the weekend down here for Bayou Classic weekend. Actually, the night of the game, after the game,
it was
Saturday night, early Sunday morning.
Who won the Battle of the Band?
Don't know.
I heard Southern won. Was it
most likely? Yeah, Southern won.
Well, you're abreast to the fan view and the fan way. Was it an upset Grambling fan that was shooting?
Well, they really don't know who.
What happened?
They have an idea. They're not releasing anything yet, but they have an idea of who the shooter is. They've been collecting video from a lot of the businesses in that Bourbon Street, French Quarter area. So hopefully the shooters will get caught. And no, they were not from New Orleans, so that wasn't our problem. We normally chill for Bayou Classic. You know, we turn up. Like, if anything, we trying to get the new fresh meat that come through to holler at your boy, you know, see what's up, and try to go home for the night. Like, that be that out-of-town beef that they bring down here, you know, and which left 9 people hurt. One man lost his life that night, and which was a sad situation because from what was reported, they were shooting from both sides of the street, and whoever was in the middle,
we had a shootout.
Yeah,
a shootout on Bourbon.
Yeah, that's what was reported.
There's so many other things to do on Bourbon.
That's what one of the witnesses stated out there, and it's a shame because, you know, innocent people that's just out there to have a good time getting caught in a crossfire. It's like one young lady got shot 5 times. She got hit 5 times.
Man.
Something that probably didn't have nothing to do with her. I mean, it's a shame.
Okay.
But at the end of the day,
I just had a thought, but I keep it to myself. I don't want to come across rude or offensive, so I keep it to myself.
Wait, hold up. You know. We got the president-elect saying whatever he wants to, and you telling me you don't want to come off as offensive? Oh, yeah, and we got a quick report, yes.
Grambling
won.
Grambling won the game.
Yeah, 52-30.
That's great. Everyone knows the game doesn't matter.
No one cares.
The game. Okay, so who won the Battle of the Bands? And if we're going to talk about the game, no one cares about the score. Who won the halftime show? I don't even think the players care about the game.
Yeah.
They just go because they have to. And they're really close to watch the halftime show.
I mean, the players probably care, but...
No, they don't. They care about the halftime show.
Who's coming?
So, who won the Battle of the Bands, and who won the halftime show? But Grambling did win the game. Shout out to you, Grambling, for that pointless victory.
Pretty much.
Still a winner, though. You won. That's worth something.
All I'm going to say is for all the Grambling and Southern fans, wrap it up. Do us all a favor. Thank you. Good night.
Yeah. Good look, man. Positive. Yeah, it's good, you know.
Straight up. Wrap it up.
You know, positive messages and encouragement. That's great.
That's the best thing to do on your campus. Please, wrap it up. Okay. Trojans are better.
It's getting less positive, man. Mm-hmm. It's getting this positive encouragement. It's getting less positive. Oh. It's getting kind of negative. Okay.
Well, sometimes it'd be like Mad Men versus Good Man. I'd be trying to.
Yeah. Did we? Let's stop it. Wrap it up. Wrap it up.
Beat.
Yeah.
Beat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. If you don't know why you need to wrap it up, it doesn't matter. Just wrap it up. Yeah. So, who won the Battle of the Bands? Who won halftime? No one cares about the game.
Pretty much.
So, as soon as they let us know, we'll let you know. Or you probably already know. So, shit, let us know. Facebook, New Orleans Talk Network. YouTube, New Orleans Talk Network. Instagram, NOTN. 504-341-8255. Let us know. I'm all working, no play. I don't get out, so I don't know.
Yeah, I've been having a lot of that lately.
Yeah. Yeah. You know. Money over everything. Put that on everything. All right, now we're going to get into this Jay the Hustler featuring the homie Gorilla Greedy. Greedy! Steven Seagal, man. They can tell you what it's like. All work, no play, man. Got to get it in. Who won the Battle of the Bands? Who won the halftime show? Don't care about the game. No one cares about the game.
Nigga, if you from the city, I'm from you from Chopper City, you heard me? Ain't no way around that.
Uptown, yeah, baby. No cut.
It's for all the real niggas hard to kill.
Gorilla Greedy.
And at the same time, they mark for death.
My nigga Hustler.
Steven Seagal. Above the law, nigga.
I'm from the spot we can see the fear in your eyes. The same spots known for leaving niggas flatline. From clap nines, where baby mamas give birth to gorillas and apes with alligator bloodlines. Woody and I, just a product of my environment. Where weed, crack, and dope are all products of the same environment. Where hustling fill the streets with hustlers. For beef at a young age, I learned to tote that heat to keep a muffler. I hit your nigga fitted up, leaving minus his logo. It goes like this, whoa, and oh, where every day's a payday. It's okay, AK, comprende. S.A., I got Burger King slugs, you can have them your way. A real love for this hoop shit, daddy, but the streets made me. From hanging on my blocks to chilling in hallways. Back in the day, they say Greedy had a hard head. But I look for success, so I try always. Fuck what you believe, nigga, I feel. Crime pays, have a fiasco like Lupe. Gorilla Greedy. Yep.
Prices up and down like a seesaw. Cocaine cowboys, nigga, hee-haw. Nine piece, quarter brick or raw. Steven Seagal, above the law. Above the law. Above the law. The way we gettin' it, a nigga feel above the law. Above the law. Above the law. The way we flippin' it, a nigga feel above the law.
I step in the booth like Superman, this purpose lit, I'm blazed. And I bet you can't need just one, we treat them Percocets like Lays. Hustler Kane Jr., I'm the one these cowards fearing. Talking reckless like my tongue ain't got no fucking power stirring. Back on my 12 shit, that 1200, that 1212, that's 12 world if you don't know. Never been? Don't go. ACH, that's J-Team, we a nightmare, you a daydream. If I date your bitch, then I take your bitch and I ate your bitch like red beans. I'm too hard, you too soft, I'm Santa Claus. call, shoot group dog. Bitch, nigga, that mean you work for me. This flow getting murdered in first degree. And I was taught to never bite the fucking hand that feeds ya. All them hammers put that ass to sleep. Call that hammer seizure. Sheesh, for Pete's sakes, and your mama's too. I wouldn't put my mama's life in jeopardy if I was you. And if I was you, I would kill myself. Some niggas change, but I'm still myself. Hustler, prices up and down like a seesaw. Cocaine cowboys, nigga, hee-haw. Nine-piece, quarter brick or raw. Steven Seagal, a bottle of, a bottle of, a bottle of. The way we getting it, a nigga feel a bottle of, a bottle of, a bottle of. The way we flipping it, a nigga feel a bottle of. Bitch, a nigga live a bottle of, nine piece, quarter brick or raw, Steven Seagal, a bottle of, Steven Seagal, a bottle of,
nine piece, quarter brick or raw,
Steven Seagal, a bottle of.
You already know what it is, man. It's your boy Jay the Hustler, and right now you're tuned into the livest show, the Live Line. You heard me? On NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com. 1200 HTH in the building. Heart to hustle. HTH. If you don't have it, you better get it. The only way to survive is with it. You hear me? HTH.
And we're back.
Oh boy.
And we're live.
Oh boy.
Welcome back to the Live Line on New Orleans Talk Network, man. I'm your host, Ill Pent. I got my guest host for the week, the Madman.
Unique.
Yeah. This real talk about real rap, man. You just finished checking out that Steven Seagal. It's the homie Jay the Hustler. Preaching Gorilla Greedy. Oh, Greedy. Shout out to Jay. Shout out to Greedy, man. The boy doing a lot. Spoke to him a few times in the past few weeks. He's been moving all over the South, getting it in, man. But everybody out there, man, we like y'all to get in on this conversation, you know. Me and Madman have a great time, but the more the merrier, you know. 504-341-8255. Instagram, NOTalkNet. Twitter, NOTalkNet. Facebook and YouTube, New Orleans Talk Network, man. What you got to say, man? We want to hear from you. I want to hear from you. Kanye, stop screaming at the fucking people. Just talk to him.
I mean, it's hard for the man. Look, I'm about to leave Kanye alone. Oh, Jesus, hey, I'm going to leave you alone, bro.
Jesus.
I'm going to leave you alone, bro.
Yeah,
my
man.
Way. Oh, come again. Come again.
Jesus.
Come again and say what?
Yeah, man.
Come again and say what?
I enjoyed the time with you, Madman. You know what I'm saying? If you want more Madman, you check him out on Thursday nights, man, on FanView, man. He's definitely going to have him back over here. But check him out on Thursday nights. Check out FanView, man.
Y'all already know how we coming. Every Thursday, 6 p.m. to 8. Holla at us. You heard me? FanView only on
Thursday. Did the boys in black and gold win this week?
Yeah, we won. We won in good fame.
You see, hell, man.
But
yeah,
at the end of the week,
yeah,
I know.
So who won the battle of the bands, and who won the damn halftime show? Anyway, shout out to the Saints. You did it. That's what's up.
About time.
Stop fucking up.
I mean,
get your shit right.
We still don't have a playoff chance, but
that's, yo, that's you think if we let Kanye talk to the Saints, they play better? You know, every time you lose, we're going to let Kanye shout at your ass.
Nah. Shit. I don't want Kanye nowhere around the floor to leak.
Nah.
Can't do it.
You don't think it'll help?
Matter of fact, I got another person for you when I was talking about the Kardashian curse.
Why?
Remember Reggie?
Reggie who? Reggie Bush?
Yeah, the Bush monster.
No, Reggie Bush. I don't remember that guy.
Yes. Reggie, when Reggie messed with Kardashian.
Oh, the other Reggie. Yes. Yeah, that Reggie. Yes. I remember, yeah.
He may have won Super Bowl.
I haven't seen that Reggie in a while.
But he went on the downslope.
That was the Kardashian curse? Oh, was it?
Yes, he had.
Was
been,
it the Saints?
No.
It wasn't the Saints, it was the Kardashian
no,
curse?
No. He was affected by the Kardashian juices.
Juices?
The Kardashian the juices.
The juices.
It doesn't just blow in Kim.
It's all of them.
It's in the Kardashian name.
Kardashian crack.
Yes.
Oh, for Reggie, it was the juices. He was healthy. He didn't do crack. It was the juices.
Yes.
Okay. And for Lamar, it was crack.
It was the juices that made him go to the crack.
Okay. So it starts with juices.
Then then they branch off and start doing weird little things. Now, Kanye is something different. Somebody already told me he likes it and boom, boom. So, I don't know about it. I don't know.
You trying to tell me Kanye about it, boy?
I'm not saying that. Amber Rose said.
Well, you saying someone else said.
Yes,
Kanye
Amber Rose
is
said
about it, boy.
Said,
what?
She says, man.
What?
She said, man.
What?
Man likes it. Then boom, boom. Yeah.
Loud and big rim nigga that my life.
I can't help it.
Yeah, my bad. Recite you going in over there. I hear you. I hope y'all can hear this, man. Now we got the bling bling in the background.
He got my little girl party.
Yeah, I got that 504 mix. It's very serious, bro. Man. Look, man, it's the live line, man. New Orleans Talk Network. Every Tuesday, 7 to 8 p.m. Fan View. Thursdays. Madman, the big fan.
Oh, 6 to 8 p.m. Always. You hear me? Only on New Orleans Talk Network. Well, real fans talk sports. You dig?
Yeah, sure.
Get at us.
It's real talk about real rap. It's real fans talking sports. This is real over here, man. It's real and it's live. And Kanye, you should stop screaming at the fucking people. Just talk to the people. Mm-mm. Stop all the fucking screaming. And who won the Battle of the Bands? And who won the damn halftime show? We done found out who won the score, but don't nobody want to know that shit.
I'm telling y'all.
Don't nobody care.
I didn't pay attention, but I got.
The players go to the game and play in the game because they got to one plus they get a free ride. But they don't care about that game. They just want to see the halftime show and the Battle of the Bands. So you know we want to know who won Battle of the Band. Who won the halftime show? Let me know. Facebook, YouTube, New Orleans Talk Network. Instagram and Twitter, NO Talk Net. 504-341-8255. Call in and let me know, man. All work, no play. Don't get out. Busy getting it. Couldn't go.
And that's a shame.
Plus, I didn't want to get shot at.
Born and raised down here, and I don't even pay attention to it no more. Sorry.
Yeah. Let us know, man. While you finding that out, we'll be over here doing what we do. You know what I'm saying? Come fuck with us. Every Tuesday, 7 to 8 p.m. It's the live line. New Orleans Talk Network. What is that? Is that a non-New Orleans instrumental you playing after all this time? Nah, that's a New Orleans instrumental. Wayne ate that shit.
Well,
anyway, we out, man. Kanye, stop screaming at the people. Madman.
Leave Kanye alone.
Yeah, don't interview Kanye.
Never.
It ain't bad. And we'll be looking for that that reality show around Mardi Gras.
I ain't gonna lie. I interview Kanye in a boxing ring.
Okay.
Yeah. We can get him gloves.
Okay. Now it's getting less positive again, man.
Nah, what's wrong? I mean, that's positive. You know, you get to release stress without really hurting somebody. You got gloves on. You can even put the little protective dummy helmet on, you know.
How much talking? Interviews involve talking.
Yeah.
How much talking are either of you going to do if you're punching?
If I'm punching on him, then guess what he's doing? Talking to the hand. Yeah, I'm stupid, y'all. Look, y'all. If y'all know me on a personal level, I am stupid. Yes, sir.
That's it, man. We out of here, man.
Hey, hey, talk to them.
Man.
Talk to them.
Come bananas.
Yeah, all day.
Yeah. Live line. We always talk network. We're going to talk about real
like
rap.
Nothing. Yes.